Now, one of the protesters, Sagie from Plainsboro, is on New Jersey 101.5. How you doing?
Hi, Steve. Thank you for having me. I'm doing well. How about you?
I'm good. So tell me about this, Sagie. How do you feel about this?
So I am feeling terrified for all of my peers, all of the residents of our country who are living in fear of having a knock on their house. Sorry?
What are they afraid of? Are you here illegally? Are you here illegally?
I'm not here illegally. No, I'm a United States citizen.
Okay, so you're afraid of a knock on the door. I don't understand that. What are you afraid of?
So I'm sorry if I wasn't clear. I'm not afraid. I'm feeling empathy for, you know, those tens of thousands of people who are living afraid of that knock on the door.
Okay, but they are here illegally and they're committing a crime, right?
Well, there is the crime of illegally crossing the border, but I would point out that international law protects their right to seek asylum. And as you know, just today, the Trump administration announced that it was going to be, waiving that ability for people. We know that there are immigration judges who have never once granted an individual asylum. Of course they're crossing the border illegally.
Okay, but that's not an of course. That's a big deal. And just because you ask for asylum doesn't mean you automatically get it. And you have to remember, I mean, Sagie, do you know that this is something that fell on the president? This is something Congress was supposed to do. Come up with an immigration plan, which they have not done. And it has been going on since the Clinton administration. The last reform was under Reagan. It was an amnesty, and he regarded it as one of the greatest mistakes of his administration. There's soundbite after soundbite from Obama on down, Clinton, all kinds of Democrats saying that, you know, that we've got to put an end to the undocumented. We've got to put an end to the illegal immigration in this country. So the point here is that, can you compare this to the Holocaust?
Steve, I so appreciate what you were just saying about the lack of much-needed reform.
Right.
I think that's something everyone across the aisle can agree on, and I really appreciate you bringing that to the center of this conversation. What I would point out, though, is that when we are having this conversation about Congress's inaction, we tend to focus on Democratic inaction when it's the Democratic...
I just said Congress. I just said Congress. And as far as as far as the sound bites, you know, those are, you know, it's basically you've got both sides. The problem here, Sagie, and I just want to ask you, I believe, and tell me if you agree, we need to get these people in a room, and by these people, I mean both sides of the aisle, and work something out. And they refuse to do that. And by refusing to do that, the situation gets worse and worse, which results in the protest that you had, you know, that you took part in on June 30th, as well as the finger pointing, and it's not my fault, it's their fault, and nothing's getting done.
That's a really good point. We need to be beginning these conversations, and when we go into those conversations, they have to be in good faith. I believe that protests like the one I participated in bring attention to the fact that we can't keep doing what we're doing. We need to come to the table exactly like you're saying.
All right, Sagie, thank you. Thanks so much for the call to New Jersey 101.5. We'll have that on the website. 1-800-283-101.5. See, and you know what? I had a woman call me a half hour ago, screaming and yelling, freaking out, right? Here, I've got Sagie, who was one of the actual protesters at the detention center in Elizabeth. And what do? We have a reasonable conversation. We come to a conclusion. Now, if two guys can do this, you know, on a Monday night, on a hot Monday night, why can't our leaders figure it out?